just last week on this show how they had Colorado right where they wanted them.
Yeah, just embarrasses 7-0 on the road, and then that's exactly where we want. And injure Nick Paul so that he can come back heroically after a dad speech saying, if you don't get hurt out there, you come right back if you're hurting, and then blammo.
Welcome to Game 4 against the Tampa Bay Lightning and the Colorado Avalanche. They're down 3-0 in this series. Multiple players injured in Game 3. Tampa Bay Lightning have signed 145-year-old Vincent LeCavalier to be their first-line center. Hey, scores!
It's going to do LeCavalier!
That would be amazing!
And it's going to happen in 48 hours from now.
We get a lot of shots. Everybody come to the net. We just have to get more and more pucks to the net.
I'm about to listen to Pucks on Net.
We used to talk about in Vancouver getting pucks on net.
Pucks on net.
What were you saying about putting pucks on net?
This is JT Miller with the Vancouver Canucks, and you're listening to Pucks on Net.
Pucks on net and driving and making a hard night on it.
While Arash marvels at a dog in Gila's fabulous backyard, I will reiterate to the listeners, live on tape from the literal House of Greed, this is Pucks on Net, a Vancouver hockey podcast riddled in rampant speculation without sources. It's a fun fact that we are gathered here today. Mm-hmm. We'll get to that. Mm-hmm. My name is Ryan Schaap. I'm going to be your host for the evening. Make sure you follow us on Twitter at PucksNetCA or PucksNetCa. You can support the show on... I'm rebranding.
What do you... Why?
Patreon.
For what? Now, for OnlyFans.
Yeah, it's a V-I-P-O-N.
Video Pucks on Net.
Sure.
Here Ryan goes with his version of Crystal Pepsi again. Okay, go ahead.
Very important Pucks on Net. That's a
We've changed the formula for Coke. You're gonna love it.
It costs the same and it's underwhelming. And that's at patreon.com/pucksonnet and go to youtube.com. Sitting to my camera.
Yeah, just go to youtube.com.
Type in Pucks on Net.
No. Don't type in Pucks on Net. Just go to youtube.com.
Oh, they're gonna
it's a great site.
They're going to watch like a Mr. Beast video.
They're going to watch Stephen A. Smith be like, Steph Curry is never winning another championship. Now, he is a disgrace to the sport. The three-point line, that should be sacred.
Stephen, what's the status on his wife's cooking?
Now, I say this with a heavy heart. Aisha Curry is a good friend.
Arash, how are you doing?
Just jazzed up. It's great.
Prince of Pomegranate. He's on the right side of town, on the good side of the tracks for once.
Yeah, I know. I'm in the crime riddled area that is Deep Cove.
There is a.
We've been robbed once in the 35 to 40 years we've lived in this neighborhood.
This is a very good neighborhood because when I turned off to come up to Gita's, there's a sign saying traffic fines minimum $138. So don't get any ideas.
Yeah. You know, this is a really good neighborhood when they just have PS5s and, the book library, the neighborhood book libraries? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Instead of books here, it's just PS5, a brand new PS5.
You know what I really love, though, in this neighborhood is those plant exchanges. I think those are adorable.
Oh, yeah. Plants are expensive.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's like that is the PS5 of shrubbery. Yeah, Gita, you own this joint. How are you doing?
Yeah, I do. Just barely. In this day and age. I'm doing well. I see that Misha's probably going to drive you nuts all night.
I mean, Misha's doing fine.
She's outside, so that's fine by me.
We got another like 2 hours of daylight. She's going to be good.
So lots happening today.
No, nothing happened.
Stanley Cup final.
Eh.
What's that?
Does Andrei Kuzmenko play in the Stanley Cup final?
You know what I could really go for? It's some bubble hockey. I'm like, damn it. August is coming around. And there's going to be days of no sports. Sports.
For a second, I thought you meant like bubble, like, oh. And I'm like, are you going to go down to the den and hustle, or are you going to make some money? But yeah, bubble sports would be ideal.
Yeah,
bubble hockey, bubble basketball, no fan baseball, which is regular baseball.
Oh, man, I just wish for no baseball, actually. It'd be great.
I'm heartbroken about baseball.
Oh, Seattle Mariners playing their 7th game this evening.
Mike Trout does it again.
Mike Trout does it
It's
again.
Over, folks.
It's over, folks. We'll see you in 15 minutes for game 8. Boys are going to go in the locker room and just get some water, and they'll be right out. We got some catching up to do. Okay, yeah, where should we start? Well,
Have some fun with Kuzmenko.
Okay, well, yeah, let's treat, you know what?
Everybody's having fun with Kuzmenko.
Let's treat ourselves like the Vancouver Canucks organization treated Andre Kuzmenko by not taking him to a Joey's.
Mind you, Joey Shipyards came up a lot today. And that one's nice. They hand you glasses of champagne.
Do they?
Are they still doing that?
They still do that.
What? I thought that was... I went there the night it opened.
Yeah.
Also the night Tyler Toffoli scored all those goals against the Boston Bruins.
Yeah.
And I thought it was the grand opening. But if they're still giving you champagne...
So we went there the night before we got Misha. They were still doing it. I went there only a couple of weeks ago and couldn't get in. Because apparently you have to make reservations at a chain.
Could you imagine Ken Hollins outside? Be like, yeah, it's going to be 15 to 20. 15 to 20, Andre.
What is this? You're not Detroit Red Wing Ken Holland.
King of Edmonton and Detroit?
Why is this man, this Kevin Lowe man, he following us around saying that he is Andre Kuzmenko's best friend? Boy.
Well, Gita,
So what I was saying is the people that were waiting to get in or waiting for their tables all had glasses with them.
Interesting.
Yeah, so it's still happening.
Okay, so when you were in there.
Yeah.
Ballpark.
Yeah.
How many NHL executives did you see wooing European top free agents to come to their squad? Like 15, maybe 20?
Oh, yeah, like at least 17 of them were there. Columbus was there. Detroit was there. They all picked that same Joey's to entice Russian hockey players to come to North America.
So what you're saying is what Ken Holland and the Edmonton Oilers did to woo Andre Kuzmenko is par for the course. You just take him to Joey's to woo him. Am I right here? There's something to laugh about.
One of my favorite jokes of today, the rampant Joey's jokes that were covering Twitter. Sam Chang was like BC lawyers don't even take their year one lawyers to Joey's to celebrate. Like they don't even take them. Like the bar is so low. Like why would you even? Oh, man, that was really hilarious. We took the World Cup away from them. We took Andre Kuzmenko away from them. We're going to take Connor McDavid away from them.
Last week, Connor McDavid's holding hands with pretty gals in Austin, Texas. This week.
No, that was his sister, bro. You don't understand.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, it's my sister. She's adopted.
Yeah. This week, he's looking at one-bedroom dens in Yaletown.
Yeah. He's like, does this have a cold presence here? Like an ominous presence? Like not really inviting for natural life? Because that's my vibe.
Some sort of slab, a marble slab in the middle of it that I...
He opted for a solarium.
Oh, opted for a solarium. Yeah. Yeah, wow. Okay, so Andre Kuzmenko, the top European free agent comes to Vancouver. We won one. He instantly becomes the best left winger on the Canucks. It spells doom for either Tanner Pearson or Nils Höglander. Nils Höglander is in the Bruce doghouse. Tanner Pearson. We got to love him. Ryan loves him.
I love a sensible stay-at-home kind of guy. Meat and potatoes. All chicken right. strips and fries. No, yeah. No dipping sauces.
All right, guys. Tell me. What do you know about Andre Kuzmenko? Just, you don't even... Don't,
He's
I don't
got
want...
dimples.
Yes.
That's
fine.
Don't
look at the computer, Ryan.
He's
look
26
me at...
years old.
Ryan, look me in the eye and tell me everything you know
he
about
him. He scored 40 goals in the KHL.
Yeah, like 20.
Yeah, 20. Okay.
But like prorated in 82. Yeah, sure.
53 points in 44 games in the KHL last year.
Okay.
And then we know that Patrick Alvin and Jimmy Rutherford have been high on this kid for several years.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And they, the effort was there. The effort was there to court him.
Yeah. Is there a reason why he was undrafted?
I don't know.
There's a lot of kind of late bloomers that kind of show up in the KHL and in Europe, right? So some people just don't declare for the draft and they just slip through the cracks.
Military obligations. They
were working overtime at a Joey's.
Yam fries?
Them, Ken Holland, is this cruel joke? You bring me back to Joey's where I worked to pay off mortgage. is this type of sick Canadian joke?
They put garlic aioli on the burger. It's really good.
No, they do not put garlic aioli. These tiny rocks. I have seen kitchen. They do not. Niet.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So. Okay. What, anything else you know about Andre Kuzmenko?
He's a low risk. He's a high reward type of guy.
Mm-hmm.
He could fall under the category of Fabian Brunstrom with the Dallas Stars some 15 years ago.
Yeah.
Okay. Or he could fall under the Kirill Kaprizov, or even better, let's not get into the crazy.
But I feel like that's the best part, right? Low risk, high reward, because in the past, we're so used to all these like gambles.
Yes.
Gambling with everything that we have.
All we have is draft picks, and if we just put them on the table, we're going to pay it off.
You're one of my closest friends. In order to gamble, you need to actually come out with perhaps winning something.
You're like, I'll get it right the next time. Just one more.
This regime literally went and took money and went to the BC Lotto Association and just gave them money at the head office and didn't get like a scratch off. They're like, all right, this is how it works, right? Well, no, you know, you can just go to like an Esso or something and they can, no, I'll just give it to you. Okay, how do I know when I win? Well, we haven't given you. Okay, bye. Okay, see you later.
But he, this is, we talked about on our bonus episode over on Patreon about just the simple glaring holes on the Canucks next year. And one of them was a second or third line winger.
Right.
And
was it?
And a center.
Okay.
Well, center. Yeah. They had a lot of like middle six wingers.
He
automatically becomes their best left winger. He's on a 1 year on an ELC, right? And then if he doesn't work out, he doesn't work out. So like comparables, like Nikita Gusev had one good season and then he flamed out. And then you have, Panarin and Kaprizov, and that's
the comparables.
I mean, it's pretty high up there. Listen, if he comes in and over 82 games, he scores like 20 goals, 30 assists, he gets 45 to 50 points. That's a home run. And then you really actually have to pay him. He comes in and he flames out like a, what is it, Vadim something. You're ship along a ding dong.
How about Sergei Shirokov?
No, okay, Brendan Batchelor brought that. That's not.
But that's a name of a flameout, coming in.
Yeah, but he was drafted and then he went back and then he came back and he had a good preseason and then they let him go.
Okay, it's been a little while since we've recorded in person.
It's been a while.
The last time we recorded in person, Gita's triumphant return, we sat and had a conversation about, and it's on our YouTube page at youtube.com/pucks.net, do the Canucks off-season plans involve Andre Kuzmenko? That is the name of our clip for that week. And here we are going, well, I guess they did. I guess it paid off. And I put this question out on the Pucks on Net Twitter earlier today, a very, plainly phrased, if it was Benning and Weisbrod that were courting Andre Kuzmenko, would he have signed with
this team? Well, would they have known they were courting him?
Would they have known to court him?
Would they know who Andre Kuzmenko is?
Yeah.
Then would they chase him down? Or would they, would the time difference in Detroit, throw them off?
I don't want to drive to Detroit. It's far away.
And would Travis Green have had that kind of impact on a player?
Oh, God.
It's
hey, you know what? You guys, okay.
Travis was in a tough spot.
Okay. But is he the kind of coach that lures a player that other people are coveting?
Mm-hmm. And we don't know that. But Gabby made that effort to drive from...
Gals?
Yeah.
I think we need to stop talking about our exes. I don't know. Is it time?
It's almost time.
Is it time?
We will stop talking about our exes.
Now let's keep talking about it.
It's not been a year yet.
Yeah, let's talk about it. Anyway, he would do this thing, right? Drove me insane. He would go to the pantry, just grab draft picks, and just throw them at anything. And then he would stumble around, running out of time, and then, pass out on the couch.
And then we would have no draft picks.
And then we would have no draft picks. And why is no one down in Manitoba? Who let this happen?
Jimmy. So, Jimmy, they haven't been in Manitoba for 10 years. Oh, jeez.
Oh, there's Manitoba.
So Andre Kuzmenko, he immediately becomes the best left winger.
Is that, what about JT Miller?
But he's not. That's not where you want Jason. Well, I mean, okay, yeah. But like, if you're running down the middle, hypothetically, in their natural positions,
yeah.
You know, it's Petey, Horvat, Miller. Like, just not in that order, but those are your centers, okay? Because it's Miller's probably number one. So he immediately becomes your best left winger. Now, guys, this is where it becomes tricky. So they have a top Russian free agent coming over. He's on an ELC, so he's going to have 925 whatever plus his bonuses and performance bonuses.
That's the other thing.
Okay.
So affordable.
So affordable.
900 grand.
900
grand. Jason, spent some money.
This is like Hustle.
Dude, I loved Hustle. That was such a good movie. So the entire movie was like, Philadelphia kind of is tough place. Just to let you know, Philadelphia has the really whoosh, not how it's not easy. And we're gonna get to Philadelphia later because I want to talk. We're gonna get to Philadelphia. So this is where it becomes tough because now on the left side they have Kuzmenko, Pearson, Hoglander. Right side they have Podkolzin, Garland, Besser.
Allegedly,
and it's like, okay, well, something's got to give. So,
there's
something coming.
There's a lot of men in the old lifeboat right now.
They have checked off like the step one of their 14. You know that thing where in what's the Chernobyl, the TV show Chernobyl. So you know when they're checking off the thing of like, if there is radioactive, if the core is exposed, go down checklist. Check one, sign Andrei Kuzmenko. Two, go over to other teams, be like, you are dumb for not trading Jade for JT Miller. Price up 20%. Check.
Okay. You know,
yeah.
Oh, sorry. I was going to say, so if you guys were a betting man, and Ryan, you are a betting man.
Ryan is a betting man.
Let's get
is coming? What if like Miller and Kuzmenko have like this undeniable chemistry?
Miller and Kuzmenko?
They better not. They better stay far away from those summer skates in East Palestine, Ohio. We want no chemistry between those two.
Absolutely not.
One of them's got to
go. What if it's explosive chemistry and now you can't separate them because they can't be without one another?
That is true.
This is what Jim and Patrick have feared the most. You stay over there.
And never play them together.
Don't you even make eye contact. I know. Because we don't want you to be sad when one of you leaves. Because we need draft picks.
So, can I give you my I've been thinking about this for a while. I think I know how to rebuild the defense.
Okay.
So, look at Tampa right now. I think you can get away with like the left side of your defense being like elite.
Okay.
And the right side of your defense just being like, hey, do you like him in the room? All right. And so like, yeah, bring in Luke. They got what? They're running like Cernak, Bogosian, Jan Ruda.
Couple of throwback
Thursdays there. And then on the left side, they have what? They have Sergachev, Hedman, and McDonough.
Apparently that's pretty good.
I don't know, man. I'm looking at the... pivoting a little bit. Philadelphia is going in full stupid mode.
Yes.
they're completely jumping the shark. This is season 8 Game of Thrones stuff. This is like, yeah, Daenerys kind of forgot about Theon's fleet. And so they're going full chaos mode, right?
Yeah.
So, like, listen, you dangle JT Miller to Philadelphia. And does he not scream, A, Philadelphia Flyer, B, John Tortorella? Does he not scream that and they want to win now and they have money? Oh, they want to splurge on money? Okay. And who else is upset in Philadelphia?
Ivan Provorov's
like, why is Travis Sanheim taking my minutes? Man, I'm Ivan Provorov. I got a cute dog. Do they have a draft pick? Yeah, they do. They got some draft picks this year, that maybe next year. Do they have some prospects like Morgan Frost just stagnating? Yeah, they got that stuff.
I can't remember if Philadelphia is the type of team to do crazy rash things to become a playoff contender immediately.
I don't know if they've ever done that.
I feel like they are.
Okay, for anyone who obviously isn't here, Reed just threw a frisbee in the yard, hitting a potted plant into the water.
But he has no idea because he's like now bent over like.
Reed has no idea. He's listening to REO Speedwagon. That's not a shade to REO Speedwagon. I love REO. A
couple of classic albums right there. But there are opportunities for quick fixes. I also do love that when you said, take a look at Tampa, Gita and I both looked at the Tampa. Yeah.
It's still 7 some?
It's 6-2.
It's hard not to look at them with hard eyes emojis.
Yeah, it is really hard. But like
you're like, I want what they have.
I know. So like obviously like you look at the right-handed market, like I don't know, like John Marino is the one guy that they're pitching and they're saying, oh, John Marino, okay, well, mm-hmm. you have to make a move that makes sense. I get that. But it's gonna be really hard because then you're gonna, you know, you're gonna bring in a right-handed defenseman, you're gonna move assets out, and then you still gotta deal with the fact that okay, you're paying OEL that much money and you're paying Myers that much money and whatever. So well, that's that.
They'll ship that money out.
I hope, man. We'll
they're
see.
Very smart.
We'll see. They got a dude. They absolutely have a plan.
They went to Blue Water. They went to Elisa. They didn't spend $19 on a lunch meal.
They didn't even go to the Cactus Club, and they should have.
Could you imagine if they went to Elisa and Andrei Kuzmenko's like, I don't want to do my Russian voice too much, but he's like, okay, I want the porterhouse steak. All sides. and Jim Rutherford's like, okay, Andre, we'll give you the sides, but you're gonna sign on the dotted line right now. He's like, nyet, I half sides. You'll get all the sides, including the hash brown gravy.
Andre, and that's $126 worth of sides right there.
$126 American dollar.
Not Canadian
dollar. There's got to be more.
That is enough to buy PlayStation 2 back at home.
Why? PlayStation 2 is great. It's a great unit. Some of the greatest games of all time are on the PlayStation 2.
But as you've said, people in my neighborhood have fives.
In our neighborhood, kids are already on the six.
But crime is rampant in Deep Cove.
138 starting.
I was trying to do the white person cackle of being, garçon, bring me a lobster fresh from the ocean. No, we're not. It's a lot of middle class people here. We're good people.
Wrapping up on Kuzmenko, Boudreau met with him and his agent in Michigan last Friday, meaning he took the old Windsor Bridge to get there. Mm-hmm. I feel like Gabby's a road tripper, probably stopping in a couple of Baskin Robbins on the way.
Yeah, I wanted to touch on that. There's a few people who are like, oh, Canucks had to send Bruce Boudreau out for 6 hours to go on a car ride. Why would they do that? Oh, and in my head, I didn't reply on Twitter, but I replied, I was like, listen, my dad's 74. You tell him he gets to drive for 6 hours and like see the sights.
Gabby, you're on the clock. You're making double time.
But also they're sent. And then there's, I want to go because I know what I can do with this guy.
Exactly. There's this buy-in from everybody in the organization. The front office knows the player well and wants to take this low-risk, high-reward gamble. And Boudreau knows what he's got in terms of left-wing depth. And there's something that could very positively come from this. Yeah, you go drive for 5 hours, and you
that's what being good
at your job is. You're selling your team. You're that's a salesman it. In that role. Put the goddamn work in.
Because he knows what he knows what he can do with that player. He knows what he'll get out of the player. He obviously has a plan for that player as the coach.
Yeah,
and so. Yeah, I would think it's stupid, ignorant, naive of you to think that he was forced to do something of that sort.
Yeah, just like, listen, man, he probably went with his wife. They packed a cooler of sandwiches.
Oh. Yeah, they probably stopped for their Tim Hortons breakfast sandwiches and double doubles.
Yeah, they got some Tim Biebs brew or
probably
whatever.
Had lunch by a nice lake in Michigan.
Sounds fun. I want to go on this road trip.
Yeah, I would love to do that.
Let's go court some high up and coming.
Six hours isn't even that long. Like, we could get to Portland.
How about this? We'll do
it. Hang on. It took me 6 hours to get to Seattle on Friday.
Whoa. Me crossing the border, get out of here. That's 8 hours in the office.
Can I tell you something really funny, really quick? And you,
Gita, do you see how she's marking out at that joke?
It was very good.
It's relatable to her and I.
Yeah.
But to Ryan, they're like, yeah, don't worry, you're gonna be fine.
So I gotta tell.
Oh, how many guns you got on the trunk? Oh, you going hunting?
You're going to hate this as two people of color. So we drive to the border.
He was in a car with three other white men.
Hang on.
Both Keita and I cross our arms at the same time. All right, Ryan. Yep.
Keyword is Ryan. We get in line to the border. Hell of a time getting there. It's slow as molasses.
Oh. Yeah.
I'm in the front seat. Errol is in the passenger seat. My friend Ryan, is behind me, and Michael's in the far right corner. Windows are down. We got
his friend Ryan Smith is in the back crying.
I don't want to stop playing. You do.
Which one of you is Captain Canada?
It's me.
So
Danny and Hank came out to shake my hand. That's so nice. No, I don't want to shade on Ryan Smith. He's a warrior, but
so the windows are all rolled down. Uh-huh. We give him all the passports.
Okay.
And he goes, okay, which one are you? Who are you as Ryan? And we both put our hand up. And he's like, instantly, like, okay, assumed fake ID. He's like, wait a minute. How is that the case? And I'm like, how can you both be Ryan?
We were both born in the 80s.
I'm like, both our names are Ryan. And he goes, oh, I didn't. He's like, okay, I see the other passport now. Who in here is Earl? And it's like, my name's Errol. And I'm like, this is it for us. We're getting hauled in, but away we went.
They're going to, yeah.
With
they
the whitest of names.
Errol, Michael, a couple Ryans.
Yeah, that's the way you're going to go down. You want to hear a really great border story real quick?
Sure.
My dad bought a truck, like a old school Land Rover. And on the back, it has a tire cover that says Eugene on it.
Yeah.
And so we're crossing across the border.
Mm-hmm.
And this guy is just like dead staring at my dad. He's like, oh, a Persian Land Rover and an old school Land Rover? What kind of Al-Qaeda stuff is he doing? You know, kind of whatever.
Yeah.
I'm allowed to say it. Deal with it. So he's like, and he like looks at the window that's in the back and he looks at the Eugene thing. And it's like, it's a thing. He's like, do you live in Oregon? And we're like, no, we live in North Vancouver, British Columbia, as you can tell by my Canadian voice. He's like, do you live in Eugene? And he's like getting older. I'm like, it's a wheel cover by a company that's called Eugene. My dad doesn't even know where Eugene, Oregon is. And I'm just like,
he's not a Ducks fan?
Huh?
He's not. He's
quack
not
quack, Mr. Doug. Oh, okay, college football. I'm Ryan. Look at these kids that I'm never gonna hear about again. But maybe one quarterback is gonna get drafted from the Ducks program. Anyway, wow, Ryan. Wow, that's.
Wait, I've got a crazy border story
Let's
too.
Do it.
So I was going down to the outlets with Karen. And we're in the line and we're probably from the actual border. We're probably like three cars back. And then all of a sudden, all the guards converge on the car in front of us with their guns out.
Oh, what?
And I have no idea what happened. It was an older lady who was like a senior who was driving and there was a man in the car and we don't know what played out.
Yeah.
We're just like, oh shit. What are we going to see happen?
Oh man.
I hadn't crossed
Bruce the border. Bruce tried to go down across the border to Michigan. Right?
They're subjecting him to these border hostilities?
You telling me Bruce Boudreaux doesn't have a nexus?
Which
there?
One of you is Bruce?
Which one of you, Bruce? Bruce, there it is? Yeah, that's me. No, that's me. Yeah, yeah.
He's got his son, Bruce Jr., in the backseat.
Yeah. Wow. That's cute, Ryan. Thank you for sharing.
Just want to thank everybody once again at this point of the podcast. Thank you very much for listening wherever you got us from. Please make sure you're following us on Twitter at PucksNetCA or PucksNetCaw. And like we always say, if you want to support the show monetarily, head on over to patreon.com/pucksonnet. Pledge a couple of bucks. Rash and I put together a really good bonus episode last week about our off-season wish list for the Vancouver Canucks, a real meaty deep dive into what we're hoping for from Alvin and Rutherford on their first off-season in Vancouver. It's a really good episode, and you can access it as well as video podcast, 5 minutes for paying, the Pucksnet Discord server, all that by pledging $5 or more a month over at patreon.com/pucksonnet. But listen, it's a recession, I think. Inflation's here. Gas is expensive. We know you can't, you know, some of us can't budget in that Patreon monthly payment, and that's fine. Help support the show. Go to youtube.com/pucksonnet. Give us a follow. Give us a subscribe. Watch our clips there. Watch our content there. It means a lot. go follow us on all our socials. We are blowing up TikTok. We're on the Instagram Reels like it's going out of style. Just go to our, find us on your social, on social media, help us out. And you can also find us on Apple Podcasts or Spotify. And when you're there, hit follow, hit subscribe, give us a 5-star rating, positive review. That awful algorithm, it goes a long way to help thwart it. They do mean a lot to us. But all in all, just listen to the show, enjoy it, interact with us, hit those likes, spread the word, put in your Spotify, in your Instagram stories if you listen to us that way. But yeah, patreon.com/pucks.net. We got a great bonus episode out. And this season's wrapping up here. We're having a lot of fun doing this. But I think we're going to go back, and I think we might have a couple of jokes at the old Maple Leafs to make here. But thanks you for listening.
Now we're back from the break where Ryan thought he was capital F'd from crossing the border, thinking like they're going to detain you for both being named Ryan. I mean, I was in the car, but like, wait, how is that so? They're white.
Oh, says it right there on the passport.
Yeah. If there were two Arashes in the car, I would be very suspicious as well.
But literally, every other guy born in the 1980s was named Ryan.
Yeah. Yeah. It's one of the most popular names.
You were probably, actually, you were both Ryan. Yeah.
It's like if you go to an Italian wedding in the 80s, everyone's going to be named, you know, Marie and Polly.
Oh, of course.
Oh, yeah, Polly. Hey, Marie. This is Marie. Hey, Marie.
Oh, man. Can you? It's a tough day in the hockey universe. Is it still 6-2?
Still 6-2, under 10 minutes ago. Let's talk about the Stanley Cup final. It's so funny that all the fun stats, all the notes I got were about how dominating the Colorado Avalanche were and how miserable and piss poor the Tampa Bay Lightning have.
And they were, except I think the last time we did an in-person podcast, we were saying that about the Toronto Maple Leafs and the Tampa Bay Lightning.
Yes. That's generally
can
how
you,
that...
Can you imagine that Toronto was one game away?
Yeah, don't worry.
Every year.
They had a chance.
They keep reminding us, bar down is just, hey, you know, the Leafs almost beat this team. TSN, here's how the playoffs would have worked if the Leafs had won.
Ah, they might have gone out in 5 in the second round.
Yeah, probably.
That's how it would have worked out.
That's how Florida would have got to the East Final, finally. Quickly on the... It's like tonight, there was that Anthony Cirelli goal, mm-hmm. 5-hole goal where he didn't even shoot. It just slid
fake,
it in.
The fake Kucherov deke thing. Yeah. But he didn't really mean to do it.
It was a total bungle. He pulled a homer. And as soon as I saw that, I just thought that's their Dan Kluche, Nick Lidstrom goal.
Mm-hmm.
That's all the
moment. Oh,
I am 100%. Tampa in 6, baby. Tampa in 6.
Oh, my God. Ryan Schaap, get out of here.
Because look what's happened since that
Believe
goal.
Oh, they're losing one. You know what happened? Let me tell you what happened. Hot take, breaking news. From the man from with the sources all across town. This is right from Rick Dollywall told me this personally. So if you have a problem with this, talk to Rick Dollywall.
Mm-hmm.
After the game two, Nathan MacKinnon allowed Darcy Kemper to have a Kit Kat.
Oh, no.
After the shutout, yeah.
It's like you deserve this break.
He deserved this break, and now
that's
he's like...
That's a good play on words. Let's identify that.
And then during the second intermission of tonight's game, he went over to Darcy Kemper, and he's like, you're going to puke until that I see all that Kit Kat. I don't care if your body's digested that sugar. You're going to make the wafer show up, and I'm going to put it back in the wrapper and take it back to the store where I bought it.
You broke...
Ew.
That's not me. That's Nathan MacKinnon.
Yeah, you don't. Yeah, you gotta be just grossed out by these championship-like tactics.
Yeah,
he's doing what he needs to do.
Yeah, he's bringing back the goji berry puree. Everyone just has an IV drip and it's just like goji berry.
And then he's conducting an interview. I'm not a weirdo.
I'm not a weirdo.
I get in and out. That's the best defense of I'm not a weirdo.
What do you get at In-N-Out?
Lettuce. A lettuce wrap wrapped in a lettuce wrap.
Here to celebrate his Stanley Cup victory, Nathan MacKinnon got his lettuce animal style.
Oh.
But this series isn't over. Looks like Tampa Bay could likely win this one. John Cooper had a famous, not a famous quote, but a very intriguing quote before game 3 against Toronto.
Mm-hmm.
Just because we're walking into Amalie doesn't mean we're going to win. I like that he thinks that because there seems to be a bit of a home ice advantage.
Mm.
I believe Colorado, or I believe Tampa Bay is 7-0. We're 7-1 at home,
okay.
And Colorado is 7-0 on the road. So
someone's bound to bring. Someone's gonna get a little L, little L in the column. You know what I mean?
Kadri is flying to Tampa. He could potentially play in Game 3 or Game 4. And if you saw tonight, Nick Paul is getting injected with Tortorella at the Wazoo, and
nice.
And he got that goal. And if you didn't see it, did you see when John Cooper had his little speech to him?
No.
So.
Oh, he said he's like. If you're in pain, get off.
Yeah, and what does he do?
Scores a goal.
scores a goal, and that's just Tampa.
That's just Tampa.
Let's move on from a fun Eastern Conference team.
Okay, what else are we going to talk about?
Well, there's a lot of head coaches getting hired.
I can't think of one head coach that got hired on a team that made me want to rethink if I want to be a fan of the sport anymore. Oh, wait a minute. I have a few that happened this week.
Is it all about the mediocre middle-aged whites that just keep getting new $4 million
a year job? Like, put all these names like on dice. Like they shook it up and somebody got one of them.
There's literally no other people that you could hire, like give a shot
there's,
to.
There's no imagination at all.
The only way
like
you...
if Imagine Dragons can imagine dragons, can we not imagine, I don't know, another coach?
Well, if you think about it,
Pete
like,
DeBoer, how is he still hired? How does he still have like?
Sure.
I wish that I could conduct or I could perform in a job interview the way Pete DeBoer performs, where he just shows up. Pete, what are your qualities? Well, I really know the Western Conference. Well, I know all the divisions.
Well, like John Tortorella, his relationships never end well.
No, they usually burn out. They usually burn out in a combustible ball of fire.
It's very explosive. The ends of his 10 years. Why does somebody keep thinking that? No, it's gonna be different this time. I can change him.
My hot take.
I can change him.
No. My hot take is that John Tortorella is gonna be the coach of the Flyers for the full 4 years. He's gonna go in there. And he represents the like everything that the Flyers are about.
Oh, big time.
Just about like chip on your shoulder. You got to give a damn.
Play like a effing Flyer, Alain Vigneault.
Yeah, play like an effing Flyer. Media is going to love him.
And there's no real star for him to destroy.
You know who is on that team? A bunch of former Columbus Blue Jackets that loved him.
Oh, no, that social media was great.
They love, like,
Brandon Dubinsky being
like,
but not
Patrick Laine.
Not Patrick Laine. Oh.
Who would have thought they're not going to give him a UFA deal? Offer.
But yeah, he's the 23rd coach of the Philadelphia Flyers. Flyers have come out and just said, we're not rebuilding. The Flyers
are
never
right there.
The Flyers have never believed in the idea of rebuilding as a franchise. Mm-hmm.
Never.
They've always been about the whole retool.
Especially with Pittsburgh in the conference where it's like we have to be able to compete with our cross-state rival.
Well, today's the anniversary of the Lindros trade.
Let's talk about that.
Let's finish up on Torts.
What else do we need to tell about Torts that we've?
You were just about to get into it.
Okay, I was just about to get into it.
I thought we were done here.
So the Flyers aren't gonna. They're gonna retool. They're gonna spend a stupid amount. This is what they're gonna do. They're gonna get rid of contracts, and then they're gonna bring on a stupid amount of money through trades and free agency.
Nazem Kadri.
Like Kadri. I would not be surprised if JT Miller's moved to the Flyers.
Because
if they go over to Vancouver and they're like, we'll give you our 2023rd first, we'll give you this prospect, Ivan Provorov, and also you got to take James Van Riemsdyk because we need cap space, blah blah blah. And then that's their big move. And then if they don't get Gaudreau, they're gonna they sign Miller to a long term thing. But yeah, I don't know why. The team is in shambles. Kevin Hayes is signed. Like, God bless Kevin Hayes. Kevin Hayes is signed to a ludicrous contract. They didn't get anything really back from the Claude Giroux trade. Mm-hmm. They have another low first from Florida. Morgan Frost is rotting on the vine on the third line. Cam York. And,
mm-hmm.
Household names.
Yeah, and they have Carter Hart, Kata Hat.
Yeah.
Travis Konecny. Dude, Travis Konecny.
A lot of players.
What a player that would be with Bo Horvat, Travis. You're telling me Kuzmenko, Horvat? No. It would be Pearson, Horvat, and Konecny. And then Kuzmenko, Giroux, Podkolzin.
Oh, are the Flyers trading Giroux?
Oh, I don't know if you've heard, but the man's just waiting for an opportunity. But I don't know. We'll see what happens with the Flyers. This offseason is
we're gearing up
to like be complete chaos.
Mm.
And there was the Shea Weber deal.
Yeah, Dadonov.
It's such a boring thing to talk about. Let's just be like,
it's cap circumvention. They're doing what they can do. I mean, it is what it is.
They're getting right. They're just LTIR money. Yeah. But
Brent Seabrook is going to win a Stanley Cup this year. So,
Could you imagine he comes out and he just lifts up the cup?
He should.
He should. He's like, I'm not getting a ring, but I'm lifting this thing
in
up.
In a Chicago Blackhawks zip up.
That'd be so funny. But it's really gearing up to be kind of one of the most bonkers off seasons because it's like you can feel it. You can feel that everyone's moving their chess pieces into place.
Mm-hmm. There's also, we're essentially having a full year of organizations making money again, and they're ready to spend.
Yeah, they're ready.
And then the cap went up by $1 million.
A big old million. That's
there. Boom. We paid for Kuzmenko there. Free. Whoa. It's literally the definition of free. Kuzmenko was free. Was literally free.
Let's talk about the carousel. Bruce Cassidy was unemployed for 6 days. He's gonna be fired. Mark it here. It is 7:59 p.m. on Monday, June 20th, 2022.
Mm-hmm.
In let's say early 2023, we'll be podcasting outside because it's such a beautiful. I'm sure there'll be some sort of patio heating out there. It's such a elaborate setup out there. But that's when Bruce Cassidy will be fired from the Vegas Golden Knights. He'll last about a year or so, year and a half.
They'll bring Pete DeBoer back.
Pete DeBoer will go. Pete DeBoer's and Barry Trotz is still without a job. But literally everybody in Winnipeg is offering anything that they sell, any retail good or service, they are.
Is there a Joey's in Winnipeg?
No, but I know a stonemason near from Winnipeg that he says if the Jets get rid of take care of him, whole front of the house is gonna look like the back of Gita's house.
You kidding me?
Oh yeah,
yeah, oh yeah. That's first hand news.
That's
confirmed. Oh. Gita, that's confirmed.
What's that?
Well, you know what I'm talking about.
She knows.
We can't. Oh, she's seen the bank statements.
I guess so. If that's what it takes to get Trotz to do the Jets,
you don't want to know how expensive it is to ship quartz from here over to Manitoba on an airplane. Let me tell you.
On an airplane.
Apparently they have a really nice quarry there.
Do they?
Oh. Yeah.
Oh.
I know words like quarry now.
Welcome to your 30s. We know the word quarry.
Welcome to your 30s where you're mostly concerned about dehydration and wearing a sensible pair of shoes to get you through a weekend.
Should we buy the $9 jar of olives or will the $7 one do it?
Well, let's wait for a sale.
Well, yeah. Oh my God. If I could change my middle name to Arash, let's wait for a sale, Mamarzadeh, that would literally be my life. Costco, going to Costco with me is hell. Because I'm like, you have a grocery, let's put that away. We're not paying. We're not paying what they advertise.
Sir, I will not be paying sticker price. For this.
I will not.
Do you have coupons?
To Costco?
Just in general, do you coupon?
I don't coupon, no. Oh. I go on Red Flag deals like a monster, though. Oh. Maybe that's how I got my Xbox and Ryan was too late to get it. Did I ever tell you about this?
No.
Okay, a little side break from hockey because really we don't need to talk about Barry Trotz.
It's almost July.
Yeah, it's almost July. It's done. Summer's done. People don't also
Barry Trotz isn't signing in Vancouver. It doesn't matter.
He's not, okay? Yeah, there's no other news.
Avalanche have the goalie pulled for 4 minutes. Something's going on.
Yeah, everything's fine. So EB Games ran this deal, Gita, back in December.
Okay.
Might have been the worst idea they've ever had. Where they said, if you bring in your PlayStation 4, we will give you the full retail value of that PlayStation 4 in credit.
Okay.
So if you bought a PlayStation 4 like 8 years ago, they'd give you like $400 for it. $330 or $400, depending on what model you had.
So free money.
Free money.
It's the Andre Kuzmenko of video game console wars.
It was crazy. Yep. And so what they said is, we'll give you that. And then do you know how much an Xbox Series S is?
No.
$410. Oh. So I was like, okay, so you're telling me I can go trade in my PS4 literally for the new Xbox?
Oh.
And I message Ryan.
I was on a bus at the
time.
Where was Mandy?
Yeah, where? Mandy.
The credit card was in timeout.
Mandy, the Uber driver told me that it's maxed out.
She should have unplugged everything and ran to the store.
I have plans to use $500 of a optimum points on a PS5.
Okay.
$500. How much is a PS5?
Like $500 of Patreon money to buy himself.
Where'd you get that PlayStation 5? I don't have to answer that. That's none of your damn business. Let's see the books.
So anyway, I went and got myself a brand new fancy Xbox. Having a great time. Me and the girlfriend love it.
Yeah. We're
playing 400 hours of The Witcher. It's wonderful. Ryan here, though, is on his PlayStation 4 playing, Bust a Move 2 or whatever.
I've got.
He's playing Tekken like a sucker.
I gotta turn it off. It gets too hot.
Yeah, I guess.
The fan starts going.
Get that thing out of the sun. It's gonna catch on fire again.
Who knew someone could play so much MLB 21 that your PlayStation will catch on fire?
I do play a lot of that.
Think of the amount of lint in that PlayStation 4.
I keep it
tidy. You could have traded it in and got a brand. It's so good.
I keep a tidy home. There's no lint in that. You keep a tidy home? Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Your dog got high again?
You keep a tidy home? Yeah, you shared that on the podcast. Now, hey, guess what? It's not the hockey anymore.
We can't confirm.
We're shooting, brother.
We can't confirm whether Stevie got high last night accidentally.
Okay, maybe she was just really worried that Andre Kuzmenko wasn't going to sign here. Is that maybe the thing?
I'm going to ask a simple.
You know what he asked us when he walked in?
What?
He's just like, do you guys want mushrooms?
Oh yeah.
and we're both like.
Like actual mushrooms or like mushrooms?
There was no explanation, no preface.
And I just said, yeah, you guys want some mushrooms? And they were looking at me like I was offering them magic mushrooms.
Yeah.
And I said, no. The good food subscription we had this week, we had a double order and it called for mushrooms. And
you're still doing that?
Yeah. Neither one of us are mushroom fans. So man is like, take these mushrooms to Gita and Reed. And I'm like, I don't think they'll want them. And they did. They took them.
We love mushrooms here.
Gita, at your wedding, how much home cooking is there going to be?
There'll be home cooking, but sort of-ish on the Thursday.
Mm-hmm.
Even then, my parents have ordered in.
Okay.
And then
from Joey?
Yeah.
It's getting coptered in.
Everybody's getting quesadillas.
Oh, those look exciting over there. They're sizzling.
Yeah, the Thursday is the kind of drop in. Come by in the evening, have some food, see what's going on.
It's a 3-day event. But, I got my invitation in the mail and I was like,
Thursday is catered by a restaurant called Sulan Commercial.
Nice.
And the food is incredible, Ryan.
Yeah, Ryan.
What's the samosas like?
Oh my god.
You have to order off their street food menu.
Ryan's so fucked. Oh, you're dead.
It's so good.
You're gonna deal with certain spices that are gonna take you to through the passages of time and
not turmeric.
Oh my god, salt?
But the owner's like a guy in like his mid-30s, like in our age group. He's young. He's got there's also a Sula on Main Street. Mm-hmm. The cocktails there are incredible. And so, yeah, that's kind of why we went that route. And then we just have a regular white caterer.
Nice.
So there's not a lot of home cooking.
Oh, it's okay.
Yeah.
Don't worry, Ryan. There'll be mashed potatoes for you.
Thank God.
I don't know.
Hopefully not too garlicky.
No.
Just salt. Yeah. In dietary restrictions. Just salt for Ryan.
Yeah, Ryan.
On this day in...
the Lord's Day. The last day of spring.
On this day, 20 years ago, 30 years ago today.
Whoa.
To the Quebec Nordiques, Steve Duchesne, who I believe was part of the 96 Stanley Cup team.
I love that he's starting with Steve Duchesne from the list of players.
That's
that
a good
alphabetical order.
Oh, okay.
You uncouth hillbilly.
I like it. You should do it at random.
Nobody calls me uncouth, god dang it. You damn fighting words, okay. Mr. Tofino.
Peter Forsberg.
Mr. I don't like mushrooms.
Oh, yeah. I recall him.
Ronnie Hextall.
Yeah, that guy.
Carrie Huffman, household name. Yeah. Mike Ricci, who I believe was part of the 96 team.
Yeah. Sure was.
Chris Simon.
Yep.
Tough guy.
Was he part of the 96
team? Yeah, long hair.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Philadelphia's first round pick in 1993, which I believe turned into Jocelyn Thibault.
Jocelyn Thibault. All right.
And Philadelphia's first round pick in 1994, which turned into... It's not listed, but I know who it is.
Josek.
Nolan Baumgartner.
Nolan. Oh, yeah, yeah. Baumgartner.
Oh,
yeah, yeah.
Okay.
And $15 million American dollars in that, the year of their Lord, 1992.
Okay. And one more name?
Well, that was the Nordiques got.
Oh, okay. Gotcha.
For a little guy by the name of Erik Lindros.
Do you make that deal if it's just Forsberg?
I mean...
Like, now, looking back at it now, do you just make the trade where it's just Forsberg?
Like, if we knew then what we know now, then yeah.
Yeah, we'd be rich as hell.
You're dealing with two centers that were riddled with injury problems their entire careers.
Mm-hmm.
Both, oddly enough, played somewhat similar styles of hockey. Now, Forsberg was, 6'1", but still played like a just ran through you type center. Lindros, though, at his peak, I think at his peak, at his Legion of Doom line, is probably, I'm not sure. Yeah, that's really hard.
Well,
if Forsberg at his peak and Lindros at his peak.
Yeah.
I'm looking at, like I just said earlier, the 96 Stanley Cup victory.
Right.
Yeah. And Jocelyn Thibault, that pick was traded for, was part of the package for Roy, if I recall.
Yeah.
And I don't think that the Colorado Avalanche win that 96 Cup without Pat Roy.
No.
And this was a hell of a
brilliant,
a supporting cast that they acquired. So that team would look vastly different.
Yeah.
I feel like they would be, if it would... It would be top heavy. You'd have Forsberg in your Sakics, but you wouldn't have much else. Mike Keane would be doing far too much.
Like, no, what I mean is, like, if...
Oh, I agree with you.
If it was just for that Lindros for Forsberg, and in this alternate reality, that we never knew that other offer existed.
Yeah.
Looking back at it now, would you be like, if the trade was literally Forsberg for Lindros at the time...
It's hard to say when you think about if it's one for one, because Erik Lindros had far more constructive, dominating years than Forsberg. And Forsberg, I believe, only played one full 82-game season in his career.
Yeah. I agree. I also think that Lindros just had so much more hype and notoriety simply because he was, a Canadian than Peter Forsberg at that time. Again, this is an era without social media.
Yeah, true.
All we know is that Peter Forsberg scores a nice goal on Corey Hirsch.
Yeah.
And Erik Lindros hates French people. And that's all we have to go on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a hell of a question.
Yeah.
What do you mean?
It's a trade that worked out for both of them. Like, yeah, Colorado won their Stanley Cup. The Flyers went to the finals. Like,
yeah.
What do you mean Erik Lindros owns Joey's?
What?
No, I'm just kidding. Could you imagine?
That's what he used the $15 million on.
He also co-signed Connor McDavid's mortgage.
He did. He did.
There was, and also on the Wikipedia, there was a vetoed trade from the Rangers.
Well, yeah, that
was it
one
for JT Miller?
Oh, man, what a package.
Tony Amonte, Alexei Kovalev, Sergei Nemchinov, James Patrick, either Richter or Van Beesbrouck. Okay, so obviously I already hate the fact that the Rangers should have made this deal because there's no way they're beating the Canucks.
But then
in the
maybe they
final.
Wouldn't have won. Yeah, exactly.
God, I'm gonna get this. I'm gonna butcher the story behind it, but it was that they made the deal with Philadelphia, and they had it in They had an agreement to do the deal with Philly.
Yeah.
And then they just turned around and they're like, this is taking too long. And then went and made the deal with New York.
Right.
And then they announced the deal with New York and an arbitrator came in and was like, no, actually, you got to honor the deal with Philadelphia.
Interesting.
What would have, let's hindsight. What would have that dynamic of Messier and Lindros have been?
I feel like the Moose would have.
So toxic.
The Moose wouldn't have had it. The Moose would have been like, this kid hasn't eaten a bag of Lay's in his life.
This kid. I'll lay him out myself at center. He's watching too many passes. The Flyers claimed that the Nordiques had reneged on their agreement and filed a complaint with the NHL. The NHL appointed Larry Bertuzzi, a lawyer from Toronto, as the arbitrator of the conflict. Bertuzzi held a 5-day hearing after the 92 draft in which he reviewed over 400 pages of handwritten notes, called 11 witnesses, including Lindros. So, yeah. They had to go to an arbitrator, and the original deal went.
Yeah.
It's, I mean, I got to think it's probably you got to imagine it's probably the best and biggest trade in NHL history.
The biggest? I mean, the biggest trade was the Gretzky trade.
Yeah, but
I just mean in terms of impact. You had people in Parliament being like, they need to not do this trade because Wayne Gretzky is literally the property of Canada.
I think it's probably because you can't remember the Gretzky trade. Well, like, none of us can remember the Gretzky trade.
I was 7 months old at the time?
Well, you don't remember being in the womb?
Arash was just a glimmer in his old man's eye, crossing the border, buying a used car in Blaine.
Yes, he's actually from Eugene.
Yeah, we can't remember that trade, and we can barely remember that era, but we definitely remember the Lindros, Forsberg, and the mid-90s.
What's the biggest trade of, like, our hockey fandom generation? Because I don't think the Lindros Forsberg trade is, like, it's when we were really young.
I mean, Vancouver, the just Linden, like, trade was massive.
Yeah,
I think the NHL, the one,
Pavel Bure one became anticlimactic.
It did.
It very much so did.
Yeah. What was the one trade that we, like, everyone? It doesn't even have to be in Vancouver, but we all were like, whoa. We all stopped what we were doing. We're like, where were we?
Like, in the last few years?
Last, like, 20 years.
In the last...
Since 2000.
Since 2000. I mean, you know, all the deals the Flyers made, or all the deals the Kings made to acquire, like, Richards and Carter was pretty big.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Man, that's interesting.
Yeah.
Looking back, I mean, it's a little longer, but again, for Joe Neuendijk's a pretty big deal when you think about the impact.
I mean, Vancouver market, I think, has to be the Luongo deal.
Yeah.
I remember just, like...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dial-up internet, you know. Shout out to my friend Mark Collins. Never listens to...
He will be now.
He doesn't listen to podcasts because he's not a very good friend, but I love him.
Thanks, Mark.
Yeah, thanks, Mark. Cheese-eating person. He loves cheese, by the way. He's a normal skinny guy. Love cheese. No, he just ran down to my house and was like, dude, Luongo's, the trade for Dave Nonis did it.
They got Lucas Krychek.
And a six, man. So yeah, it was Luongo. I'm just trying to think.
We'll think. I want to mull on that. Let's touch it up.
I think any listeners that, you know what, if you want to get a little saucy on a Monday night, you know, attack us on that. The Twitter, send us your in the last 20 years, the biggest trade in NHL history.
Yeah, especially in the salary cap era.
Salary cap era.
Yeah,
let's see. I want to see what the internet has to say.
Okay, well, Gita, you look it up, the biggest
Ryan
trade.
And I will vamp.
Okay.
Well, we'll do a couple questions here, and then we'll wrap up the show. Looks like the game's over. Looks like it's 2-1 series. Looks like Tampa awoke and everything is fine. And Tampa in six. That's just me, though. Ryan Hank, Always 94. Is Pucks.net available on Zune vinyl or burnable CD?
Vinyl, yes. Burnable CD, yes. Zune.
We're working on it.
We're working with Microsoft to get on.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Team of Solani.
Solani.
Big one.
That's a big one. I don't think the Jeremy Roenick one was that big.
To Arizona or Phoenix? No.
The Phil Kessel one was big at the time.
There you go. That was a huge one.
Now looking back on it, it's like Sagan and Hamilton.
Jesus. Dominic Hasek from Chicago to Buffalo.
Yeah. That was a big one.
I've already talked about that. Sergei Bobrovsky.
Yeah, the Bobrovsky deal.
Yeah.
But still, it's not a trade that we talk about in the same way that we'd be like, it's the anniversary of the Bobrovsky trade.
Right.
And I'm pretty sure the Lindros trade tree is still living on to this day in some capacity. Like, it is it's ingrained.
Actually, I think this one's pretty substantial. The Brendan Shanahan one to Detroit.
Yeah.
Oh, well,
that's 95, though.
It's Paul Coffey, Keith Primo, and a first rounder go to Hartford.
Hartford, right.
Yeah.
That worked out well for Hartford.
Well, I mean, the Shanahan thing was so hilarious because there's the entire offer sheet thing that happened was Scott Stevens, right? And then Scott Stevens, I think Scott Stevens is the only person to sign two offer sheets in his career.
Really?
Yeah. Well, because he was playing for Washington and then. What was it? St. Louis wanted him? Oh, the story's really convoluted. Look it up. It's hilarious.
Yeah.
It's a great story.
Couple.
Oh, this one's a good one. One game into the 1989 season, the Devils traded defenseman Tom Kervers to the Toronto Maple Leafs for a future first-round draft pick.
Scott Niedermayer.
Yeah.
And then they moved that draft pick for Alan McCauley.
Yes, I think
was
so.
It, was that the deal?
I think it's Al McCauley. Yeah.
Oh, man.
Bless them.
I believe Scott Niedermayer won a Conn Smythe trophy.
Probably.
So I will ask this question. This comes from Roger R. Smith, Cool Indian 101. Who is your Pucks on Net MVP for the Avalanche and the Tampa Bay Lightning? We're going to assume Conn Smythe trophy winner. So
McCarr for me. Yeah. I just think Cale McCarr's
yeah.
Person. Cale McCarr. I was trying to think of a potential Tampa Bay Lightning on the way here. And it's like
Stamkos has been pretty great.
Stamkos has been good, but I feel like we got to see another game out of Tampa.
I could see Cale McCarr winning it on a losing team.
He's getting the Jaguar treatment.
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Hey, I know you wanted this big, pretty cup, but how about this pointy one made of wood?
He's bawling his eyes out. Gary's just standing there and be like, this is a good decision. I think this is great. This is really going to highlight how fair our league is. Gotta love it.
Erica's 47 Erica's on Instagram. Will anyone be signed to an offer sheet this offseason,
yes.
Arash?
Yes.
And if so, who?
Oh, what? If so, who? Wait a minute.
Oh, that's sorry. That's from that's Ryan from Abbotsford.
Wait a minute. That's Erica didn't ask and who. You pulled an audible, you sneaky sneak. You can't. You're going to do that at the wedding? You're going to do that at the wedding? We're going to have a nice
pull
little
the old
script.
Switcheroo.
We're going to have a nice script and you're going to take the mic off the stand and just have the wire hanging out just being like, "All right, time to party here," you know? Just
how about cancel culture? can we cancel culture?
Let me tell you about this one samosa I had, okay? And then just I was just being like, God damn it.
That'll wrap it up for the podcast this week.
That'll wrap it up for you.
I'm canceled. First in person one in a few months now. Feels damn good.
It feels good to be back again, and then we're gonna in what is it, 2 weeks we're this entire organization's not going to look the same.
We're just collapsing the podcast? Is that what you mean?
I think you meant the Canucks.
I meant the Canucks. Pucks on Net will last forever. The Canucks on this roster, on the other hand, I don't know.
So we'll go into 5 minutes of paying after this. I don't know what we're going to talk about.
I don't know.
Probably about some border escapades, who's to say. But on behalf of me and my shiny new hat... I will.
Took him an hour and 2 minutes to mention his new M's hat. When's the last time?
I wanted to compliment it, but now that he's mentioned it,
it's just like,
my shiny new hat. Thanks you for listening.
Did your head get bigger? It's a nice hat. I'm just trying
Let me tell you about the one time I tried to buy Ryan a hat.